guys are really gonna boo me. Really? You know, guys, if you've been following our Facebook,
Chuck,
shut up. If you guys have been following our Facebook, you've heard an announcement that we're supposed to be getting a new BCW commissioner right here tonight.
Well, guys,
I'll lay some bad news on you. It's not me. And once I found it out, it wasn't me, I wasn't even going to show up tonight, but I was contractually obligated to be here. If I wasn't showing up, there would be some fines, and as you guys can see, I got some scuff marks and a wrinkled suit. So, how about now I introduce your new BCW commissioner, Mark Green.
In case you didn't realize, that makes me your boss, Danny. Don't think for 1 second I don't have the lawyers looking over that contract that Capelli signed with you. We'll talk later. Don't worry about that. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to VCW's Broken Hearts, Broken Bones.
Chuck,
as you just heard, I am the brand new commissioner here in VCW, and some things are going to change going forward. We got a ton of great stuff coming up. We got a new TV show we're working on, lots of stuff, and I do want to take a second to apologize for our late start. Some of you, I'm sure you know, hit the traffic as well. It caused a little havoc with our schedule, but I thank you all for your patience. We have a great show for you tonight. I do have to start with a couple of announcements first. As though some of you who are following us on our Facebook page are aware, Brandino Davis, unfortunately suffering an injury, unable to defend the VCW Livewire Championship. Tonight we will have the Luck of the Draw tournament, where individuals will be pulled out of a hat to compete in three singles matches. The winners of those matches will move on to the finals, where they will compete for the Livewire Championship. That's going to happen here tonight. You're going to see a new champion crown. Speaking of championship matches, as you might have noticed, sitting at the commentary table with me here tonight is the Dynasty Bo Douglas, who was scheduled to take on Nick Fahrenheit in a rematch for the BCW Heavyweight Championship. Unfortunately, due to injury, Bo Douglas unable to compete here tonight, but he is contractually obligated to be here, so I'm putting him to work anyway over there with me. So, to straighten out the situation, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome, coming out here, the new BCW Heavyweight Champion, Nick Fahrenheit! Our first event of 2015, and I can't think of a better way to kick it off than having you out here. I know this is scheduled to be your first defense of the VCW Heavyweight Championship since winning it. Unfortunately, Bo Douglas unable to compete here tonight.
That's right, Bo is unable to compete. And you know what?
I kill you!
I prefer to hold this title.
You almost did the first time.
On the line tonight. I'm a fighting champion, and I'll face anybody. Me, personally, I prefer someone like Tim Lennox. Someone that's working hard and someone that's trying to earn their way back to a title shot. I prefer someone like that. But if someone from the Brotherhood wants to step up and try too, I'll take on any of them also.
Hey, there's plenty of Brotherhood members.
Allow me to reintroduce myself. My name is
Fahrenheit. I think that hurt him.
Evan Six! You are suspended! What are you doing here?
Oh, You know, the funny thing is, Twitchman suspended me.
Good job, Toots.
He's not here anymore. So that kind of leaves a void in the loop. Best thing about that void is, I'm here now. And, I got a nice little phone call the other day from...
Hey, Evan!
From Bo Douglas. They told me that, kind of needed some help. I've been gone for what? 3 months now because of you?
Yep, because of you.
3 months?
Because of what you did.
What did he do again? Oh, yeah, I hit Tim's dad with a chair.
Hey, Evan behind you. Evan behind you. He's right there.
Tim, I swear to God! I've been waiting for him to come back, Tim! Not now.
Do me a favor.
Not now. Sit down. Sit down! I don't want to have.
We have a commission that's finally doing something.
Finally? I still don't like him, though.
You know what the fun about this thing is? This title. APW title. An actual thing. Not this VCW crap. I've been gone for, 3 months now?
3 months.
Yeah.
3 months I've been waiting.
And I've been in a real thing. Winning real belts. Unfortunately, he lost yours.
Hey, he stole that belt from me. It's
yeah,
right.
He did.
Phoenix!
And all these stupid fans out here. There's one.
There's definitely one.
No, I like the side one. Except for Necky over there. This belt doesn't belong to you anymore.
Chucky.
Come on, get up, man. Get up.
Get him, Nick. Come on.
How are you doing?
You know what?
Stick?
How about this main event?
Go stop him, Vic.
You and I. For my title, for your title. Let's just have a fun time. What do you say, Nick? What do you say?
Bring it, you fat little...
Whoa. Hey.
Hey, if you want a match, get off of him. No.
Sorry. You guys got it now?
Yeah.
Got the main event. You know what's fun about this, Fed? Nothing. You know what's going to happen at the end of this night?
I'm going to make it fun, don't worry.
Yeah, but you and I are going to go out after this.
It's cool.
There's three things that I thoroughly enjoy. One of them's drinking.
Come on. We'll get them lit. I know.
Another one,
we'll get them
girls.
We'll get them lit.
Stay back.
Stealing girls. Like over here.
You're good at doing that. You're good.
And the other one's collecting belts. This one needs something. That one's going to help hold this one up. On top of my...
Get away from me.
So go back.
Beat you with my cane.
Run away. Let's get the show started. I think this is the Brotherhood VCW show right now.
It is.
Oh, yeah. I think it is today. See, you got like one or two fans that don't like that, but no one else said anything. Anybody?
Guys, you heard it. We now have a main event match for the evening. It's going to be Evan Six.
Thank you. The drink.
Kicking on the soon-to-be former BCW Heavyweight Champion.
Hey, it's Kyle!
Hey, Kyle! What's up, Paul?
Awesome.
I can come with you, brother!
Mark Green, you poor bastard.
He's a mark.
All right, guys, how about I do what I do best, and let's start the show.
I don't know if they can handle everything.
I don't think they can.
No.
New year, new me.
Same DB.
Hey, watch your mouth.
Never gonna change. The following contest is scheduled for one fall, and it is a first round match of the BCW Livewire Championship Tournament.
Get live on pole.
This is, of course, the first match of the BCW Walk of the Draw tournament. We're going to find a new champion here tonight, Bo Douglas.
Are we?
Absolutely.
Yeah, that's what happened in the tournament for the championship.
This is the future of doing the wrestling. future. We are watching New England Wrestling in the ring right now. These two young men.
Yeah. Such a situation here, Bob.
You have to be at least as tall to ride the ride.
You have to be this tall.
Give me that money, Pete.
Where'd you get those
jeans? Yeah, I got them half off. I saved money that way. But the point is, I came back to VCW looking for actual competition. This isn't competition. I know you're putting your head through a wall, my head through a wall, and I'm not trying to have the same result when you put me in the ring with guys three times my size. How is that fair competition?
Just because Ryan's not here, you don't have anybody your size.
I do have to bring up the point that your head is the same size as them.
Valid point, but the rest of me is not, and it's still not fair.
Yeah, you're going for
you wanted an opportunity.
You know what? There's gotta be two people here that are dumb enough to step in the ring with you. How about you? You wanna get in the ring?
That's my voice.
You're useless anyway, thanks, but. Huh? How about this guy with the coffee, nice and energy? We're gonna do this? Come on, let's go. Let's go. Come on, I found myself one. What? I'm offering you a chance to step in the ring and wrestle for me, and you're gonna disrespect.
He's a 55-year-old man.
Who else?
Whoa, whoa.
Stand up.
Yeah,
are you gonna wrestle? Are you gonna?
Sit.
You know what? Besides the gray hair, it's not bad. You wanna wrestle? I said not bad. It's not good either, but it's like you sit down.
He will kill you. Chaotic situation here at the Bell Tower.
You, Flash, stand up. You dress like a Flash, that means you got speed, agility, quickness. Great, come with me. Who else? Who wants to wrestle? Come on. You? You look like you're ready to do something. I don't know if it's wrestling, but all right.
Stick around. Pay attention, buddy.
They're the team.
of Carlos Gabriel and Drew Solo, Jobbers Incorporated.
Yes! Every team,
I'll take it.
Let's go, guys. Come on.
I'll tell you what, though. I don't
Jobbers
That's what you need to do.
Okay.
Is
that
you?
Why do you think I have it?
Would that make sense?
Let's go. The question now is, who is Mike Davis opponent on this
show? Well, I don't know who this is, though.
Coastal Korea, weighing in at 190 pounds, Kevin Hart!
Ladies and gentlemen, this is going to be an interesting contest. Kevin Hart making his BCW debut. He is taking on the Pimp Daddy, Mike Pava, who is looking to get on track here at BCW. We're going to find out if he can do it here tonight in a big way as he looks to become new Live Wire champion. But he's got a long road ahead of him.
Damn it! I'm the pinky!
Yeah.
anybody.
Himself with the Brotherhood, and we're going to hopefully settle some of those issues in the coming weeks and months, but we'll get into that a little bit later on. This man is a former from DCW heavyweight champion in Slam Dance Tonight, Kim Work.
I was 5 seconds away from dropping the check. had the power to do that?
Absolutely, I do. You want to check the manifest? My name's
Mark. Look at it today, you don't have much power at all, Mark.
Really? I've made matches, I've signed new talents, and I've put together a tournament. How you doing?
Pretty good.
Ladies and gentlemen, we accept the vote. Did you notice who it was when I picked your place, Chef Mike?
I already knew who it was.
So why'd you keep asking me?
Because he told me.
And we are on the way.
Ends.
And I'll tell you what, Tim Lennox.
Kyle, you got this, Kyle.
Tim Lennox has a lot of history with the Brotherhood, and tonight I'm going to get a chance to take a little chunk of the armor if he can beat the veteran, Kyle Storm.
Colorado will tie up.
And Lennox drops out of one. Lee Storm with the power. And oh, look at that. The veteran just sweeps the leg out and takes Lennox down. And now, Lennox looks a little move, taken off back guard by that move.
Taken what?
Taken off guard.
Taken what?
Off guard.
Back off guard, I think you said. What is taken back off guard?
I said taken back or off guard.
Hey, I think Tim Lennox just cheated to get an armbar on Kyle Storm.
Yeah, look at that. Kyle Storm with that straight forearm to the face, and now those laces right across the boot.
Across the boot. That's where laces go.
Right across the face of somebody.
And a nice smack across the face. Teach that green you respect.
He appears to have hurt his face.
He did hurt his face. And he just ripped his face off.
And that is what Kyle Storm will do. This guy is merciless in the ring.
Listen, he's one of the truest athletes I've ever met or stepped foot in the ring.
He has a vicious streak in the ring, perhaps unlike anybody else.
Well, he will kick your ass, because he's kick-ass Kyle Storm.
Sure.
Oh, look at that arm, Mark Green. Is that arm supposed to bend that way?
Not at all. And you can see with that arm interlocked,
that arm is not supposed to bend that way ever.
Oh, look at this. Tim Lennox just screaming in agony as the crowd at the Belltime Club tries to rally.
Did you know that Kyle just got back from Mexico?
Really?
Yes, he had a vacation there with his lovely wife.
Oh.
We made sure that he was here for this tournament, Mark Green. Don't worry.
So you think he Tijuana win a championship tonight?
No, he will win the Live Wire championship tonight. Mark my words.
Look at that spinning elbow by Lennox. And now finally getting something going here.
That's a bare elbow.
That's a back elbow. Executed.
No, there's nothing like
that. They're already wrestling tonight.
Put him in the ropes, almost tying him up.
Yeah, that's
off the ropes, Mark Green.
Off your side.
And a flippy clothesline thingy.
Not sure how much impact that actually had.
I don't think it had any impact.
Enough to get Kyle out of the ring and at least regroup.
No, he's just hanging out with Lizzie. Hey, look, Evan Six circling the ring. Hey, he's up on the ring.
Oh, watch out.
Power in numbers, brother. Power in numbers.
When I get my hands on you!
What are you going to do? What are you going to do? Give me a punch in the face.
For the better part of a year, Evan Six has been in the head of Tim Lennox. And it continues here tonight with the return of the Architect of Anarchy here to VCW. He has picked up right where he left off.
Kyle just broke his head.
He is so far into Lennox's head, he's making Pop-Tarts in his mind kitchen.
What?
Yep.
What did you just say?
Come on, Tim.
Hey, okay. Tim's gonna tap. He's gonna break that arm off. I know Kyle. He will rip you limb from limb.
Literally.
Where's the tap? So I can know what it is.
Oh, you've done that already. Hey, what do you do? Learn some respect, kid.
There's shots to the midsection by Tim Lennox now.
Really?
I'll tell you what, Tim Lennox is surrounded.
That is for me.
Tim Lennox is surrounded here tonight by Brotherhood members. His chances can't be great.
He's not really surrounded. There's only three of us here.
On every side of the ring.
There's four sides to a ring, Mark Green.
I'm aware of that.
That was a running butt in the corner and a one-handed bulldog.
And now Kyle down. This could be it.
but no, Kyle there for the veteran gets it still on the ropes.
Commissioner, I think I can get used to this.
Yeah.
I can sit out here and watch every show.
I got him!
And Evan sits pitchfork in the ringside area.
No.
Oh,
the headbanger is not gonna work.
It'll work if he connects with it. And watch out, Feeney again. Feeney gets involved at all.
Okay, maybe those three.
Oh, he's got him hooked up here. Oh, the storm warning. The storm warning by Kyle Storm into the cover two, and that is it, ladies and gentlemen.
That's actually a choke.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner and advancing to the final round of the BCW Livewire Championship Tournament.
That's called a choke collar neck breaker, Mark Green.
The Brotherhood successful in
as always, just like Evan Six will be later. Tonight we're going home with two brand new pieces of gold.
Well, Kyle Storm better not get too comfortable because we're going to be having that
that's
final.
What's happening. Sean Feeney, good job.
We're going to be having that finals next, though. Kyle Storm not going to have...
Hey. For me, yes, I want to see this one. There you go. Thank you. I appreciate it.
That one's for you.
Thank you.
I don't know if you saw it. That was a win.
That was. We're going to have three of those tonight. Three wins.
I'll tell you what.
We're going to be 3-0 tonight.
I'll tell you what. Kyle Storm better get that quick breather that he has because that championship final is coming up next, Bo.
Next? It's next. No, that can't be possible.
It's next. Kyle Storm.
That doesn't make any sense.
Oh, it's a shoot. Kyle Storm is next.
That can't be next.
The championship final is the Livewire championship final is next. But what are you talking about? I'm telling all you guys what you're supposed to be doing.
So why are you
ladies and gentlemen, I have a little business to take care of.
Do that. Keep stepping. Move. Walk. Kick rocks, Mark Green. Something's wrong with that kid. I think we've beaten him too badly.
Gentlemen, coming up next,
sweater.
After this, is the finals of the VCW Livewire Championship Tournament. You've seen all three men events. But before we get to the finals, I want to call up the current, at least for the next few minutes, VCW Livewire Champion. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Brandino Davis. Brandino, welcome. I know how hard this has to be for you. I know you've put in a lot of work to get to this point, to capture that championship. You defeated Jason Rumble. This is not an easy thing for you. And believe me, I hate having to do this.
He cheated!
But I did tell you I would give you a chance to address the crowd here at the Bell Time Club, so here you go.
He's on the disabled list.
Was the best thing I've ever gotten. Better than any championship race. Better than anything.
What? He's in the ring. Way better.
No, please. No.
Go cry to your mommy.
It's a black thing. Well, before we finish,
Doc, is that true?
Hello? Bird. This is the hardest thing I've ever had.
Good job, Doc.
I'm mighty well for work. This is everything to do. But I'm telling you right now, those three dudes put me in a corner, and this dog will bite. I'll tell you that for a fact.
Oh, wow. Well, Brandino, I'm sure once you're back and ready to compete again, you'll make another run at taking that championship back. But for tonight, I need you to sit down. When the champion is decided, I'm going to ask you to present the title to the new champion, please.
Why is he stuck together?
Ladies and gentlemen, it is now time. We are going to find out who is going to be the next VCW Livewire champion in just a moment.
It's post-dated.
He wants to work for free, I suppose. He wants his check signed.
It's pre, it's pre-Mark Green.
Of the BCW Championship Tournament, the winner of this contest will become the new BCW.
I don't want papers on my desk these days. Let me just forget to sign that check. I don't know.
That's gonna, unfortunately, not gonna happen.
Getting right into the face of Bambino Davis.
We have kick-ass Kyle Storm in this match. I'm telling you, Mark Green.
We're gonna find out.
Oh, Michael Jackson's back. He's from Neverland. He's not from
Dimas.
He's from Neverland Ridge.
Mr. Casanova making his way out.
You know, he did have an impressive showing over Dan Terry. I will say that, Mark Green.
When you come in on your first night to beat the fitness man and Mr. Casanova there in VCW.
True story.
That was an impressive debut. And tonight he looks to cap off that impressive debut by leaving here the Live Wire champion.
I think Doc Goldberg wants to say something to you.
Both of these competitors, super light in the boots. That's all I have to say.
Could be true.
Those comments.
Could be true. When I speak it, it's extremely
could
true.
Be true.
Those comments belong to Doc
Goldberg.
What a heater, Mark Green.
All right. And we know who the third man is, of course.
That's right.
It's kick-ass Kyle Storm.
That's right, the Brotherhood.
Who we saw
representing once again.
Who we saw just moments ago. Advance to the final.
That's true.
Now, if I'm getting this correct, you're wrestling him tomorrow? Is that the deal?
Yeah.
Oh, I am so sorry.
Soften him up, Kyle.
Oh.
Soften him up.
Of course, Kyle making reference to tomorrow night at the APW event, Christian Casanova taking on Evan Six.
165 pounds. Kick-ass Kyle Storm!
Whoa!
Evan Six has just told me
what?
That whoever, if it's Mike Baeva or Kyle Storm, whoever wins this, if you beat Christian Casanova, he will personally give you $1,000.
Evan Six putting up.
Hold on. I want part of this. I need $1,000.
Evan Six putting up. Putting a bounty on the head of Christian Casanova.
If Christian Casanova wins, he gets absolutely nothing but a beating from Evan Six.
I look at it this way. 500 better than nothing. So the two of us are
going to
clean you up.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, that's apparently a new twist on this one is a bounty has been placed on the head of Christian Casanova.
As you know, the Brotherhood has unlimited resources, Mark Green. Unlimited resources. We have private backers, private investors, Hey, of course we have private parts. Everybody has private parts. No. Michael Jackson.
And the call here is probably behind this young man who is looking for his... Oh, look at that.
Oh, that's number one. Oh,
they are in track.
his head off.
They are, in fact, teaming up here tonight.
That's what happens. That's what happens, Mark Green.
When a bounty is placed on a guy's head.
No, no, when the Brotherhood's in the ring.
What, pay with the Brotherhood now?
No, no, he's just, he's glamorous, and the Brotherhood, he's glamorous sometimes.
Kyle Storm taking his time, catching a breath. I mean, the guy just competed against Tim Lennox just moments ago.
He's up?
Hooked up for the big suplex coming here.
Casanova up. He's still up there.
Look at Kyle Storm just walking around the ring holding him up.
Still there.
Got all that blood rushing to the head as Christian Casanova is going to come lightheaded here. And then the impact as he crashes down to the canvas. Ladies and gentlemen, still to come after this contest, the VCW Heavyweight Championship on the line. Another member of the Brotherhood, Evan Six, looks to capture.
Look at Kyle with his pinky up. Look at the unity that these two are showing.
Kyle Storm will sell out Mike Pava in a moment's notice.
No, he will not. The Brotherhood is very honorable.
Kyle Storm wants the championship, and if at any time he sees an opportunity to take advantage of Pava, he will sell him down the river. Believe me.
Let me just let you know, Mark Green, Kyle Storm tonight is going to walk away with $1,000 as well as the Livewire Championship.
Well, that's entirely possible, though. I'm not going to deny the credentials of Kyle Storm in the
no,
ring.
No, it,
doubt
it,
about
I'm
it.
Telling you.
Right now.
Fact.
Oh! Beautifully executed by Christian Casanova, but he realizes he steps up and he wants to execute the cover, but he looked up and knew Kyle Storm was similar.
Kyle didn't kick Pava right there. He saw how quick Christian Casanova was, and he did not kick Pava.
But you got to credit Casanova, his presence of mind, to know to be on the lookout for Kyle Storm.
Well, look at this. He's calling him out. I think he's drawing a line.
Maybe
take his hand. Yeah, go ahead.
Maybe the young man has earned some respect from Kyle Storm. And that's an endorsement for sure. Is Kyle Storm asking him to team up against Pava?
Wait. No. We don't hang out with Michael Jackson. I don't think that's a good idea, Kyle. No, you know what's going on, Mark Green.
Oh, now they're all offering to split the money with Christian Casanova.
Money
happens if Casanova agrees to lose the match. He has to be pinned in order to collect the money.
Yeah, but he doesn't need to know that. He can dance, but is he that smart?
Oh man.
Not that smart.
Kyle Storm convincing.
He just agreed to a $1,000 ask.
Oh. I always pay a lot of money.
Well,
Kyle Storm.
Doing your personal time needs to stay in your personal time.
Oh, my God.
That hurts.
That sickening sound of flesh on flesh echoing through the bell time corner. Watch out. Evan Six now. Choking out Christian Casanova.
It's not happening. I don't know what you're talking about, Mark Green.
And Christian Casanova has it all. Kicks to the midsection.
Oh no, what is going on here? No. So, there we go. Pava, there, pinky's up, Pava.
And now, Pava into the cover, two-in. Casanova able to get up. Oh, Storm.
He gets up to a kick, Kyle Storm.
There's just no way Christian Casanova can win this match. He's just simply outnumbered here tonight. Yeah.
Holding them open, they are destroying. Look at Evan Six right now, Mark Green. He looks like he's going to get in that ring and eat Christian Casanova.
I'll tell you what, it's quite a compliment to the young man Christian Casanova that Evan Six is so concerned about his upcoming match with him that he had to put a bounty on his head here tonight.
It's not a bounty, it's just added incentive.
Look at this.
That's not even possible.
Can he take advantage here? He has
not
to.
Not even possible.
He has to cover somebody quick as both men are rattled.
So he's up before the two of them.
Oh.
No, and a drop kick to the face.
Oh.
Drop kick to the mush.
Again, executed beautifully. And if Christian Casanova wants to win this match, he's got to get one of his opponents out of the ring. Storm goes to the outside to catch his breath. And he executes that beautiful clothesline.
Michael? Did I just go Michael?
And now, Pava going into the welcoming arms of the Brotherhood on the outside of the ring. Casanova has to find a way to take advantage here. Oh my God! He took them all out! And that is how Casanova can win this match. He has to do moves like that.
Yes, happened, Mark Green. Mark Green, I don't quite understand what just happened. All I know is I see Evan Six on the ground right now. Be careful, he might steal that girl as well.
And Christian calling for the count out. If both of these men are counted out, Christian will be the live wire champion.
I don't even know why Tuttle's counting. There's no three, there's no count outs in triple threats.
Well, I could award him the title if I want to on the count.
Yeah, that's fine, but I got the rule book right under the table, and I know there's no
count. But being a commissioner, you can make the rules as you go along.
You can make the rules all you want, but I know the rules of pro wrestling.
Oh, they're not going to clarify that.
And Kyle caught him. Oh. Nice elbow to the back of the head. Kyle's going to watch out.
Oh, a scissor kick.
No, Kyle, get out of the ring, Kyle.
Can he roll him over?
Ring. Oh, Pavel.
Oh, Pavel with the low blow. And the cover's got the ropes. That's it.
That's not. Wait a second. Wait a second.
Here's your winner, Adam Moore. TCW Wildfire Kiffin.
So wait a second. How does this even happen? Wrestling matches? What is going on here?
Brandino Davis leaving the building completely dejected. And now Christian Casanova inviting this young man into the ring to celebrate. What a great moment. And I'll tell you what, he may not leave here with the Live Wire Championship, but Christian Casanova made quite an impression in his VCW debut belt.
A fan favorite here. Kyle, are you all right, Kyle?
You got scissor kick.
I don't think that you're getting the $500 from Peter.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we are just moments away from our main event for the VCW Heavyweight Championship.
Let me see Evan Six destroy Nick Farron.
Champion versus champion, title for title, the APW New England Championship versus the VCW Heavyweight Championship. Nick Fahrenheit's first defense since defeating. Who did he defeat for that title again?
I don't know.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's go up to the ring with Sean Feeney for the introductions of our main event.
The following contest is scheduled for one ball. And it is for both of VCW and the APW Championship.
No, it's actually not.
That's kind of pretty.
Looks like Evan lost his girl already, too. There he is!
No, she's handling some business elsewhere.
I heard she handles a lot of business.
She does. She handles all the business of the Brotherhood.
And the Brotherhood and anybody else that's got $5. There you see Nick Fahrenheit
as well.
The VCW's heavyweight champion. A man who has proven everything there is to prove here in VCW without a shadow of a doubt.
Nick Celsius is in the ring.
He has defeated every person, regardless of weight class, put in front of him, and now he is.
First,
the heavyweight champion.
Representing the Brotherhood, he is the APW New England champion, Evan Six.
Oh! Yay!
Boo.
and his opponent from Tucson, Arizona, weighing at 167 pounds, he is the BCW Heavyweight Champion, Nick Fahrenheit.
How is he the heavyweight champion? He only weighs 100 pounds.
Well, he's the heavyweight champion because he beat you. Well, ladies and gentlemen, AC Mike Doobie holding aloft that VCW Heavyweight Championship. Of course, we'd be remiss if we did not mention that the APW New England Championship also on the line in this contest.
You got clearance, right?
Yeah, I talk to people.
Okay.
When, like just now, on the phone?
Don't you worry about it, Phoebe. You'll be lucky if you're here next month.
Oh, we'll be here. Don't worry.
We are underway. Ladies and gentlemen, this is going to be quite the contest.
I think the tassels are going to get in the way of his performance.
Well, Nick Fahrenheit moves around the ring like a cat, and this is going to be quite a contrast in style.
Oh, he kicked. Oh, hey, those kicks are a little rough.
We have the power and size advantage of Evan Six
being very smart.
Nick Fahrenheit's got to stick a move here early on. He's got to hit him quick and get out of the way. If he gets caught with some of those power moves of Evan Six, it could be a very quick night.
Okay, why don't you go over there?
I'll tell you what, Finny,
go over there. We'll go hold it.
I'll hold out. You hold Evan's belt.
Look back.
No, let go of the belt, Buck.
Wow, he's a little firecracker.
Fahrenheit.
Be careful.
Well, bro, keep in mind, Nick Fahrenheit was attacked earlier on. He's got a chip on his shoulder. Nick Fahrenheit.
He is a baby. That is all that matters. He is sitting there. He is whining about getting attacked earlier.
He got his up from behind, bro.
This is a man sport. Mexico. The ref day, I mean, he knows how to count to three. Can't count to five. Count to three, though.
Well, Nick Fahrenheit doesn't want to win.
See, Kamish hires some refs.
Nick Fahrenheit, I don't screen the refs. Mike Dooley's the head
official. Like I said, former head official Kevin Quinn's in the audience. We can bring him in. We can have him ref the main event. Because your refing quality, your choice of refs, I should say.
I am hard at the refs around here. I have nothing to do with that.
Kevin's ready to go.
Evan Six needs to get in the ring here.
Not Evan. Kevin is ready to go. Evan's taking his time.
That's a trait of the Brotherhood, I think. They spend a lot of time in the outside during matches. Well, that gives me an idea. Evan likes to spend...
He won't let it happen.
Oh, look at that.
I got you.
Oh, clubbing forearm, sickening thud.
Sickening.
Evan Six.
Because it was six.
Are you going to spend the whole night repeating everything I say?
No, I just can't believe that.
I mean, I know I'm good, but if it's that good that you have to repeat everything I say, it's kind of useless to have you out here. And the crowd here getting behind Nick Fahrenheit.
It hurt bad. It hurt deep.
Oh, poor little Feeny hurt himself.
Hey.
You know what, Feeny? You think that hurts? Wait till you see what I got lined up for you.
Oh, Evan's calling for Jake to stay. Oh, here we go.
Oh,
there we go.
Snap him off. There's left hand.
There's three.
Little southpaw.
There's the big one. Those kicks are tremendous. And there we go. Not gonna.
Oh!
No!
Drop kick, took out the knee, and that's exactly what Fahrenheit needed to do!
Oh.
What a contest we are seeing here! Fahrenheit pulls that leg off the ropes, but only gets a one count.
No, you shouldn't even have gotten one.
And, Bo, you know well how hard those kicks from Nick Fahrenheit can affect you.
No, I don't. No, I don't know what you're talking about.
Did he kick you that hard and you forgot about it?
It never happened. I don't know what you're talking about. Nobody ever saw it. No. Let's not go.
Watch this.
No, Evan, watch out.
Oh, doing the web stand. Here comes it. Oh, 4 feet right down into the chest cavity of Evan Six, and he pulls him out of the corner.
End of the rope, though.
So somebody's gonna check these refs. I just seen former ECW Extreme Enforcer referee Paul Richard walking in the door. Maybe we can get him on the payroll.
Oh!
I mean, we have Kevin Quinn here. We got Paul Richard. Let's get some real officiating in this ring, please.
I don't know if these cameras caught it there, but Fahrenheit was on the top rope. Evan Six shoved Mike Doobie into the ropes and knocked Nick Fahrenheit off the top rope.
Never happened. Never happened.
And now he's got a tape wrap around the throat.
Chin lock. He's got him in a chin lock. That's all he's got. I don't know what you're talking about.
This has been as physical a contest as we've seen in the Belltown Club in quite a while.
It's been pretty brutal.
Evan Six comes into every match with a chip on his shoulder, but tonight it seems even larger than usual.
Well, I told you, we're going to take that title back. Joey Rage stealing Evan Six's wrist tape. I think he tried to collect it just now.
Oh, did you think he wanted it back?
He might want Evan Six's autograph.
It's possible. Oh, Evan Six could be the VCW heavyweight champion by the time tonight is over. Watch out, look at Phoenix getting involved!
Well, Phoenix's not doing anything.
Oh, and Phoenix got a stop sign as Tim Lennox stood up over there.
Phoenix does have a manager's license. Don't forget about that, Mark Green.
Oh, Phoenix got a wrestler's license, too.
No, that was a one night only.
Oh! There's some paperwork up top. Let's have a look into this. Into the cover, Evan Six, 2-0.
Evan, put him away.
Evan Six came very close to capturing the Live Wire Championship. I'm sorry, the Heavyweight Championship right there. Speaking of Live Wire,
become consistent.
Please once again want to congratulate Mike Taylor for capturing the Live Wire Championship here tonight at Broken Hearts, Broken Bones.
Yeah, good question, Mark Green.
What's that?
Who's the senior official?
Mike Doobie.
He is a senior.
Yes. He's got that, look at Evan Six now. Really got that knee right in the back, adding even more pressure.
Yeah, he's breaking his back. Another one that's going to make it humble.
And now,
get ready to ring that bell. He is going to quit.
What would happen?
I'm telling you, Mark Green.
What?
We're going to see a VCW heavyweight champion named Evan Six, the architect of anarchy. Forearms. That's what he's going to have to do, but he can't
stop. Oh, my God. What a drop kick by Evan Six.
That's
on
the knees drop.
Unbelievable. Where did Fahrenheit get it to kick out of that ball?
Yeah, I don't know.
You've been in the ring with this man. Fahrenheit has a heart.
I have not been in the ring with Fahrenheit. What do you keep talking about?
You know, when he beat you for the heavyweight championship.
He did not beat me for the heavyweight title. It never happened. It never happened.
Boy, he knocked you really straight, didn't he?
Never.
That bullet kick really knocked you on straight. Oh, look at that. Oh.
I left it in the locker room one night, and all of a sudden, he's the champion.
Evan Six just brutally, methodically stalking Nick Fahrenheit.
He ripped the skin off of his back, Mark Green.
Just destroying him and taking tremendous pleasure in doing so.
He is going to take pleasure in doing it.
Oh, shot
right there. He's going to win that belt. He's going to walk away a rich man. He can pay off Paver and Kyle, and he'll be good to go.
Oh, it's got a suplex.
And then tomorrow night, he will go on to defeat Christian Casanova.
Into the cover, two, and lackadaisical cover.
I don't want a two. I want a three.
By Evan Six again, lackadaisical, and Nick Fahrenheit able to roll his shoulder.
Break him.
Can you stop cheerleading out here and just commentate?
You do what I want to do, Mark Green. You do not control me.
Look, he's got that cross face.
I don't know you.
Cut that cross.
My purse.
Hold him up. Fight back.
Yes, very little. He's got him. He's got him. Double murder suicide.
He's got that crossface locked in now.
Double murder suicide. Best finisher on the Indies.
He doesn't have, and if you notice, he doesn't have that leg across the arm while walking in place.
Because his arm isn't long enough to fit between him and legs.
Oh, look at that. Shot to the midsection by Fahrenheit. Now trying back to
no
that
effect.
Face.
No effect.
Needs to
no play. Effect.
He needs that separation, and now he's trying to get it. There it is.
Whoa, rapid fire.
Nick Fahrenheit has no quit. He will not die. He keeps fighting no matter what. Over the top. Oh!
He kicked him in the face.
A variation of an enziguri.
He kicked him in the face.
Into the cover to it. Evan Six.
It's okay. No, not just anything.
Just got that shoulder off the canvas.
He got the shoulder up long before the three. Evan, watch out. Watch out, Evan. Evan, watch out. That's what happens. And you yell at me for cheating. You yell at me for cheating. He just kicked the ref.
Nick Fahrenheit went for the Pele.
He went for the Pele on the ref.
He inadvertently kicked Mike Doomy.
No, that wasn't inadvertently. That was on purpose.
And where's the goal? Shot Feeney with a chair.
No. The ref's not there. Everything's legal.
Sean Feeney has the chair in hand.
Everything's legal.
Tim Lennox chasing Sean Feeney away from the action.
Tim Lennox.
And Evan Six has the chair. Now Tim grabbed it. Tim Lennox! Did you hear that? Tim Lennox yelled, that's for my dad!
Where's qualification?
Where's Kyle? Where's Kyle? Kyle still in the ring! This is not okay!
I'm ready to crack him!
Feeney, no! This isn't okay!
Get up, get the ring announcer.
Mark Green, what are you doing? Yeah, you laying down, putting your hands on an unlicensed wrestler. This is not okay!
Where's Mike?
Mark Green, where are you going? Mark Green.
All right. I'm gonna suspend him. That's what he's gonna do.
You better be using that chair.
Enough from the Brotherhood here tonight.
What?
And I think we've seen quite enough between Tim Lennox and Evan Six. This thing has gone on far too long. And Kyle, you don't want to get suspended either, man.
Dude, you better get another one.
So here's what we're gonna do. March 20th. The next CCW event, March 20th, East Boston Night. I'm going to make the match, the one you've wanted. Tim Lennox versus Evan Six. However, I'm adding a stipulation on this thing. Because at the event following that in April, Tim, you're getting your match against Sean Feeney. And here...
This is insane. This is not okay.
If you can beat Evan Six, you will get to pick a stipulation for your match.
No, that's not all right. That's not okay. That can't be okay.
Sean Feeney will get to pick a stipulation for your match. That's the rule. And I'll tell you what, Nick Fahrenheit, you seem to have a whole lot of unfinished business with the Brotherhood, too. So March 20th, he's Boston High. You are going to go one-on-one with the man who is the center of everything Brotherhood-related.
That's right, I am.
And Jason Robach for the VCW Heavyweight Championship. Now, I suggest you guys back off.
I can wrestle.
I think I'm doing my job.
Ladies and gentlemen, we thank you for joining us here at VCW Broken Hearts, Broken Bones.
This ain't okay.
Please join us in March for our next event, where we are going to have Evan Six and Tim Lennox one-on-one. And Nick Fahrenheit versus Jason Noble one-on-one. Please follow us on Facebook for more updates as they become available.
Thank you all, and drive home safe. He's in a chair. Somebody's in a room.
I'm going to be right there.